Hello YouTube. So straight away going to the point now. Today I'm going to change the amplifier gain tuning because I have dropped down from DVC sub to SVC and that's 500 watt RMS at 4 ohms. So this is the website Kicker Test Tone. You should follow this website because these are most accurate and clean test tones available on the internet. And we all know Kicker is a reputed brand, so they won't cheat us. Okay, so rather than scrolling up and down, straight away go come down to this KMA series amplifier. This amplifier is not having any automatic smart gain tuning detection, so this is the clean test tone available and will work for all type of amplifiers. Now just download this 50 hertz test tone for your monoblock amplifier, as 50 hertz is most efficient and accurate point. And make sure you download 0 dB version, okay, not the minus 10 minus 5 dB version, because 0 dB will give you distortion free clean audio. And I am using the same file from years for all the setups I had and never had issue with it. So now let's go down to the procedure. I have downloaded the file, so you can read over here. 0 dB is designed for audio files application to give you distortion free output with the most dynamic range. Whereas if you go for minus 5 and minus 10, there you will get some kind of clipping or distortion. They clearly mention it. So always prefer 0 dB. Now come down. We will follow all this step physically and I will shoot as much as I can for you guys to make this video simple. I already made one gain tuning video, but this time I'm going to show the practical how to tune the gain on amplifier with the help of digital multimeter. So I am making this video. Okay, now we have downloaded the test tone. Now I will transfer this test tone to the pen drive and will play pen drive directly from head unit. Please don't use the external sources like your Bluetooth or your aux cable to follow this procedure, because gain tuning by internal decoding will be most efficient and accurate one. Okay, now we will follow all these steps and how to calculate the voltage, AC voltage required. Okay, for that we will go into the calculator, and just you have to do is square root of your RMS wattage that your amplifier is capable of or your subwoofer is capable of. Now in my case I need 500 watt RMS for my subwoofer, but my amplifier is rated for 400 watt RMS clean, so I will consider 400 watt RMS only. Multiply it by your impedance or the resistance. Okay, so it's 4 ohm single voice coil subwoofer. Okay, so I will keep this 4. What if it's dual voice coil 4 ohm subwoofer? Then if you are connecting dual voice coil subwoofer in parallel, then the impedance will go down to half, that is 2 ohm. Okay, if you are connecting that DVC 4 ohm subwoofer in series, then impedance will double to 8 ohms. So this is simple mathematics. You can even study this from Google. I'm just going to share the tricky part over here. Okay, now as you have seen, my amplifier is tested for 420 watt RMS clean on dyno, but to be on safer side, I have entered 400 watt RMS only at 4 ohms. So what we did is multiplied the impedance with the RMS wattage needed. Now close the bracket. Don't forget to give the bracket, otherwise your formula will be messed up. Okay, so 400 into 4 is 1600. I will show the square root directly. That is 40. Okay. Now you can do another thing if this sounds confusing. First, you can do is multiply your RMS wattage with the impedance. Okay. Now take square root of the answer. Okay. So I am sure that I have to tune my amplifier keeping the volume on 75%. And then I'm supposed to play the test tone, and slowly and gradually I will increase the gain so that I can match to 40 volts AC output from the speaker terminals. I hope this is crystal clear. Now let's get into the car and we will start the tuning. Okay guys, I am down now. Now let's first discuss about the tools needed for the gain tuning. You just need the simple screwdriver or Allen key, whichever suits well for your amplifier. You just have to do nothing, just have to turn the gain knob with this, and you need this simple digital multimeter. This is multi-purpose use. Okay guys, you should have this in your home even though you are not pro in the car audio or anything like that. So in this case, for tuning the amplifier, you have to set it on AC voltage. 200 is enough limit because we just have to tune it around 40 volts AC. Now let's get started. I purchased this Digitech ring light and Boya BY-M1 microphone. I'm right now recording from the same Boya BY-M1 microphone. You must be noticing better audio quality. Now first let us disconnect the supply from the subwoofer. Never forget to disconnect the supply. Okay, this is one of the most important step. Now we have disconnected the supply. As you can see, this bass tube looks good in the boot, and I have lots of boot space, usable boot space now. Now let's get inside the car and tune the head unit properly. Then we will move to our amplifier. I already transferred file from my phone to the pen drive. Let the head unit start. This is in off mode, so audio settings won't be visible now. These are grayed out. So this is plus point of this head unit. You can keep the custom wallpaper. So see, by default the test tone is playing. Now I'll keep this test tone on repeat mode. Okay, this is repeat file mode. Let's pause it. Now we can go to settings, go to audio, graphic equalizer I will keep to flat so that I will be accurate, fader balance to zero or on the center, mute level off, source level off, subwoofer is on, okay, speaker level is all zero. Now this is the most important part. Now I am going to play 50 hertz test tone. Listen carefully. I am going to play 50 hertz test tone for the subwoofer. If you keep this HPF off, okay, or if you have the stock head unit where you can't keep the HPF tuning, so 50 hertz test tone will repeat to play from all your four speakers, let it be door speakers or anything. You can't turn them off. So this is plus point of having good head in it. Now I have kept this HPF off on both of the speaker, front as well as rear. Because of HPF, what it will happen, I will play 50 hertz test tone, but it will not be audible. Okay, just it will send the signal to the subwoofer. See here. So subwoofer LPF is on, and for speaker, high pass filter HPF is on. For subwoofer, low pass filter is on. So I will do the purpose to the best. Okay, I am safeguarding all the speakers from the bass frequencies all the time, so they are gonna lost forever. Okay, so this is the tuning you are supposed to do. Keep the HPF high. What happens because of this, I will give you the demo. Let's play the test tone. No audio. This is the 75% volume, 30. Pause. प्ले, नो ऑडियो, ओके, नो डिस्टॉर्शन, नथिंग. बट नाउ नाउ जस्ट टू गिव यू द डेमो, आई विल टर्न ऑफ द HPF एंड नाउ यू विल हियर द बेस फ्रॉम द स्पीकर्स एंड हाउ बैड इट इज फॉर योर स्पीकर्स. लेट मी गिव यू द डेमो. नाउ यू कैन सी HPF is off for front as well as rear speakers. I will play same test tone. All speakers are distorting. And you can imagine how horrible it is for your tiny speakers. You may even end up blowing them. That's why always invest in good headset. Don't buy trash like the Android Chinese shit. Okay, and your stock holding it is sometimes better than that Android Chinese shit, but always go for such branded products like Pioneer, Sony, JVC, Kenwood, anything you like. So now HPF is on. I gave you the demo why HPF is important. And even if even in your daily life, you are safeguarding your speakers from the distortion of the bass. This is all. Now let's go down to more settings. Bass boost is worst feature you have in your head unit or amplifier anywhere. Always tune it down to zero. Loudness kept on high. You should keep it on setting which you prefer to keep. For Pioneer head unit, this is mind-blowing feature. Loudness you should always keep on high, and sound retriever on max mode. In this head unit, it's mode 2, so I kept it on mode 2. So these are all settings you should tune before going to touch your amplifier. I hope everything is clear. Now I've kept this on pause. We are good to go, no distortion. That means HPF is working fine. Now let's keep it on 75%. That is 30. 75% of full volume. What is full volume for this head unit? It's 40. Now turn it down to 30. Now what I have to do? I have to connect my digital multimeter to the speaker terminals of my monoblock amplifier, and then I am good to go. Now just have to play and tune it to the 40 volts AC. I will show you the further procedure now. So guys, now I connected the pen drive and the 50 volts test tone is ready on 75% volume. As you can see, I have zero gauge wiring and there is no scope to move my amplifier here and there because that is most difficult task. Connected my digital multimeter right now to the speaker output. Here we have got only three terminals, so no confusion so far. I hope you can see that. So there is first terminal for the gain tuning, second is for bass boost frequency, and third one is for the bass boost level. So as you know, I had bass boost, so there is no bass boost activated right now. We just have to tune the gain tuning. Right now the tuning is made for 600 watt RMS at 2 ohms. So it should come around 32 to 33 volts. Let's play and see how much it is. Always remember, you should keep your car on position. It's 32.5, we can say. So it's pretty much close. That's 600 watt RMS at 2 ohm setting.
Okay guys, now we are going to tune it for 40 volts AC, that is 400 watt RMS at 4 ohms. So this is my ring light and I connected my Boya microphone so that you will get all the clarity. Always remember to keep your ignition on, your car is on right now. Then only you will get the full potential from your alternator and output. Now let's increase the gain slowly. It's really difficult and challenging job. Sorry for the delay and inconvenience. If it gets too lengthy, I will trim down the video. Pause it. So guys, there was some problem in this digital multimeter. This is cheap multimeter anyway, so you can see the wire broke off. So I was unable to get the final load of 40 volts and wire went even hot. So I'm pretty sure amplifier is sending the voltage, but this cheap multimeter is not able to trace it. So now I will buy a new multimeter. So this was all the procedure for gain tuning. You just have to tune it according to the desired voltage you want. This multimeter is not going above 33 volts. I don't know why. I will buy new true RMS multimeter this time and will tune my setup accordingly. So this was all the procedure how to tune your gain yourself. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, drop your comments below. Live loud.